I came up with a pretty quick and easy pork and beans recipe that is fairly inexpensive. It resembles a stew, but it isn't, and it doesn't take all day. It took me a little over an hour, but that includes time for camera work. The process involves a little prep work, such as cutting up the meat and a few other ingredients and cooking them in a large pan on the stove. Here I have almost 2 pounds of pork tenderloin. I'm removing the connective tissue and some of the fat. There isn't too much fat on here anyway, so a lot I won't bother with because I don't want to shave off too much meat in the process. I wouldn't want to use much more meat than this because I'm going to be cooking it in single layer batches in a skillet, and I don't want to do too many batches and potentially have some of the meat resting for too long. Plus, I'm working with limited space in the pan. I want pieces that are going to cook fast, so I cut some small, thin slices by cutting parallel to the muscle fibers, then slicing those into thin pieces, cutting perpendicular to the muscle fibers. I think cutting the meat into short sections before cutting along the muscle makes it easier. Otherwise, stuff like this happens when your blade migrates and gives you uneven bands of meat. Once that's all cut up, I crank on some salt, mix it together, and let it sit while I prepare the rest of the ingredients. Next step is to finely chop a couple shallots, which I don't feel like doing by hand, so I'm going to roughly chop this and put it in this handy string-powered food processor thing and whoops, overfilled it. I put in a half at a time and pull the string 6 times each. This cuts in all sorts of random angles. If that bothers you, by all means, chop by hand, but this is going to get cooked down into a sauce, so I don't think it matters too much. Okay, so I got my 2 shallots finely chopped in this bowl for when I need them. I'm putting pineapples in here. If that sounds disgusting to you, don't do it. I'm just going to pour the juice out. I'll use it later. Since I didn't look at which can of pineapple I was opening, I'm going to cut these into chunks because that's what I wanted in the first place. I might be crazy, but I'm snipping apart a dried California chili into the pineapple juice to hydrate. I think this is the kind of pepper you are supposed to put into a stew or something whole and take out at the end, but since this isn't a stew that's going to cook all day, I'm cutting it up into pieces small enough to tolerate in each bite. They end up being kind of papery and can be pretty obnoxious if you leave them too big. That's most of the prep work. Now I am setting out some molasses, red beans, and tomato sauce to have ready for when I want to use them. Just before firing up my stove, I coat this pork liberally in olive oil. This should have warmed up a bit having sat out at room temperature, so that should help it cook fast without cooling the pan down too much as I add it. This is my 12-inch skillet and I have it heating up on medium. I want it to be hot before I add anything. I test it by spraying some water on it. The scattering droplets show that it is at or above leaden frost temperature, so when I put my pork on it should form a sort of steam barrier that prevents sticking. I take care to lay all the pieces flat so they cook quickly and evenly. I just give them a couple minutes aside. Notice the water coming out. I think I should have had the heat higher. Once they look mostly cooked, I remove this batch onto a plate and fry the next. I end up getting worried about the fond burning, so I start moving stuff around a little more and kind of using the meat to scrape some of it up. I would like this to be more brown, but I don't want to overcook it, so off it goes. Sometime during the 3rd or 4th batch, I end up turning the heat up almost all the way and wishing I had earlier. This cooking process might look familiar to anyone who knows how to make beef stroganoff because that's where I stole this idea from. I happened upon a recipe video and thought, cool, but beef is expensive, so I broke the recipe down into its basic form. Small pieces of lean meat browned, rested, and mixed back into an oniony pan sauce. I changed most of the ingredients but kept the process very similar. That's batch 4 of 4, so now it's time to cook the shallots. Heat is still high. In they go. I move them around to try to keep the pan below burning temperature. I also decide to add a couple forks worth of minced garlic. If you think I am a psycho for using dried pepper the way I did, I suppose you could add a fresh pepper or several along with this stuff. Once this is nice and soft a couple minutes later, I slowly pour in the peppery pineapple juice. If you don't want the pineapple, maybe just add a little water at this point, or some kind of wine might be nice. Now I can really scrape that fond up. I let that heat up for a couple minutes and add the chunks of pineapple, along with a couple spoons of molasses. Stir that around for a few moments. Now I slowly add in a can of tomato sauce. Slowly because I suppose it's better to not pour it in all at once and drop the temperature suddenly. This sauce has a lot of liquid, so that is part of why I'm using a wide pan. I don't want the sauce to be too thin, so I'm using a pan with a lot of surface area to help it evaporate. Here goes a can of beans that I didn't drain. I'm hoping some of the bean starches help thicken this up. You can add as many beans as you want and that your cooking vessel allows. Now I add the pork back in to allow it to heat back up. Some of this pork might be undercooked, so I'm going to make a point of letting it simmer in here for a few minutes. You know, if you wanted this to resemble more of a stew, I suppose you could add more tomato sauce or whatever other liquid you wanted to thin it out. But I like it like this. This is really good with rice, which I totally forgot to make. Here, it's the next day, and I needed a shot with rice. There is just enough sauce to coat the rice and make it so it isn't swimming in it. So that's it. Something inspired by beef stroganoff that isn't beef stroganoff. Let me know some things that you have come up with that were inspired by other recipes.